Candidate Gorman, a lot was made about whether the 2020 election was free and fair. Do you believe it was? And if elected Secretary of State, what would you do to ensure that elections remain free and fair in Arkansas?
Thank you, Brandon. Thank you, PBS. Thank you, Christina. Thank you, Steve. I'm very happy to be here today. And the short answer is yes. I believe that the 2020 election was a free, fair, and sound election, and I believe that President Joe Biden won the presidential election. And as sad as that day was, it taught Americans that we have to treat democracy as a fragile institution, that we have to work hard to ensure that it exists in the form that we want it to exist in. So, as Secretary of State, I'm going to work hard to ensure that all Arkansans are participating in the process. We have the lowest voter participation and turnout in the country, and that's a way to ensure election integrity is to change that statistic.
Thank you, Ms. Gorman. Mr. Thurston, 1 minute.
Well, that is the million-dollar question everyone's been asking for the past, 2 years? And I believe it's the same question that was asked when Hillary lost several years ago. So that concern and that fear has been among voters since the beginning of probably the first election, back when we just penciled in the name. The short answer is I positively 100% can tell you with certainty that I don't know. Because each state, according to the U.S. Constitution, shall run their own elections and certify those elections. So for me to say that a particular state did it perfectly, I can't say that. I can say here in Arkansas, during record turnout, a pandemic, no doubt, we had probably the safest and most secure elections in the country. In fact, Arkansas ranks, according to the National Heritage Foundation, ranks number 4 in the nation in the area of election integrity. And so I look forward to talking more about that because there's a lot we can say pertaining to, especially the last presidential election.
Ms. Gorman, 30 seconds.
Well, I'm concerned to hear that we can't all agree about the 2020 election still and on stage with the individual who oversees elections in Arkansas. Yes, Arkansas has got integrity and we've had no voter fraud complaints. And again, we went red, and so no one came after Arkansas in the 2020 election, but that could have been different. We saw the President of the United States go after members of his own party because they certified election. They did their job, and he came after them. So we have to ensure that Secretary of States, in particular, once they're elected, act in the most nonpartisan way.
Mr. Thurston, 30 seconds.
So the reason that I can't say for certainty, I can tell you what the certification said, is because I'm not there. So it's definitely assuming too much for me to say that every state ran their election perfectly, because every state is, you would be shocked at how different each state is when it comes to their election laws and what they carry out. One state has voter ID, one state doesn't. One state's a vote by mail, all vote by mail. Another state is limited to absentee. So, but I definitely am very confident with what went on here in Arkansas.
Ms. Munoz has the next question, first for Mr. Thurston.
Thank you for Mr. Thurston. So there's no doubt that election integrity is incredibly important. So when it comes to a potential voter in Arkansas, are there too many hoops to jump through? Are the safeguards and protections just the right amount, or should there be even more?
So I tell people that you have to take ownership of your vote. Some states have an automatic voter registration. Here in Arkansas, you have to register to vote 30 days prior to the election that you want to vote in. That's what I mean by taking ownership of your vote. You do need to register. There is a lot of debate on some of the election laws passed here in Arkansas in this past General Assembly. There were several. Some call it voter suppression, as if voter ID is somehow suppressing votes. But we do want it to be convenient. We do want it to be easy for people to vote, obviously, but also hard to cheat. And accuracy is more important than convenience, in my opinion, because elections, it is the bedrock of our republic.
Ms. Gorman.
Again, when you look at the statistics of us having the lowest voter participation and turnout, I would argue that we have made it extremely hard to access your fundamental right as an American to participate in the American election process, American democracy. There are things that we can do today that overnight would change that, things that have been tried and true in several other states. Online voter registration. Most Americans conduct their business through a tool in their pocket, their phone. We are making it extremely difficult in this day and age for Arkansans to access what truly makes America and American democracy different from any other country in the world. And on day one, I'm going to be addressing this. Again, if you're going to be judging the performance of this job, the first thing you should judge it by is how many people are participating in our elections.
Mr. Thurston, you have 30 seconds, sir.
So during the primary that we just had and, well, even the general election before that, we had record turnout and record participation. So I think we are seeing it trend up. Obviously, we should do a better job educating our young people, because I believe that's where we should be telling them first, when they're young, the importance of voting. Because once an individual is into their 60s and 70s, they're pretty well set. They're just not going to vote. But I do think we need to do a better job in educating our young people, and I hope we have time to talk more about that.
Ms. Gorman, 30 seconds.
I believe this office should be the Chief Civic Engagement Officer for the state of Arkansas. I absolutely agree that we should be talking to not just young populations, but all populations. We can look at data and look at who's not voting and can develop strategic strategies to address those populations and meet their needs, not expect them to come to us.
Thank you, Ms. Gorman. And a question for Ms. Gorman. You have indicated that you want to assist underserved communities and women. Is there something unique to the Office of Secretary of State? How can you do that with the Office of Secretary of State?
On the campaign trail, I talk about being an opportunity advocate. I've seen how opportunity transforms lives. I've seen how it's transformed the lives of women when you give them access to an opportunity that already exists. I look at this job as the position in statewide office that really has the most opportunity to help all Arkansans, not just women. Opportunity is a rising tide. It lifts us all up. So when I say that I want to work for women, I want to work for all of our communities. I want them participating in the election process, because your voice is your vote, and that is important.
Mr. Thurston.
So we all wish we could do more, I mean, at every level. But when it comes kind of to back up into the previous question about participation, voter registration, and those sorts of things, as a constitutional officer, there's very little room for advocacy, because your job description is set by the Constitution. It is set by state law. You don't get to define your job. And if you're going to do a outreach or a voter drive or try to get more people to participate, which group do you pick? And that's why it's a very fine line for the chief election officer to go to any particular group and encourage them to vote. Do I go to Northwest and we'll focus on that area? Do I go to the Delta? And so even though it does sound good, and I wish we could do more, it also takes resources to make sure you're doing it across the board and you're outreaching every Arkansan, encouraging them to register and to vote. So,
Ms. Gorman, 30 seconds.
I'm a successful CEO of a nonprofit. I know how to do a lot with a little. And I believe that you absolutely should expect your constitutional officers to be advocates. And I've done a lot of work with our existing constitutional officers, other state agencies, on creating programs and opportunities for all Arkansans.
Back to Mr. Thurston for another 30 seconds, sir.
I think you do advocate for people's rights. But again, I mean, back to the voter registration part, because I've heard this over the years, you know, increased voter turnout, increased voter registration. John, what does the Secretary of State do? Well, we do put an ad in a magazine that goes to every senior in high school that has an application on to register to vote. So at the very least, when they're a senior, they do have that opportunity. But you do have to be careful. What demographic, which part of the, who do you encourage to vote? It kind of crosses the line.
Got to call time, sir.